This is my funky whistle prototype. So in this video, I'm going to build a nicer version of this whistle.
So far, this is just held together by clamps, so I could still tweak it. So we have basically two whistles side by side, and they each have sort of a P in them that twirls around. And here's where the air comes in. And we have, there's one side of it with sort of a P inside, just a piece of dowel. And then on the other side, we have a very similar sort of whistle. The difference being that the other one is a fair bit smaller so that they make two different pitches. The larger one is a 1 3/8 inch Forstner bit hole, and the smaller one is 1 1/8 inch. The closer the ratio of these, the more dissonant it will sound. But if you make them too close, they'll actually end up sounding in sync, because whistles very close to each other will tend to synchronize. So we start by marking about 4 centimeters, or just over 1.5 inches from the end, and that's where the hole goes. So the air channel needs to come in just below tangentially to this here, so I'll just draw a line here for where the air is supposed to come in. And then the hole for the sound to come out, we'll make that hole roughly like so. So this will be the top of the whistle here, and we'll have the hole right here. Now the bandsaw leaves a bit of a rough edge where I just cut it, so to get smooth airflow, I'm going to sand this. Before I go any further, I need to test this out, and it turns out this actually didn't sound that good. So I made another one, and let's clamp that together just to see how that's going to sound. And I need to clamp that right in the middle just to make sure I have a good seal around, and put this in here. You may need a second clamp to get this to stick, and I'm going to use the splint to make sure I have the gap about the right size. And let's clamp another one on here.
And here's the other pitch. I'm gonna cut the P for this whistle out of this piece of 1/2 inch dowel.
Now the length of this piece of dowel needs to be a couple of millimeters less than the thickness of my whistle body. So I set the fence here, and that should work out just about right. I'm now ready to glue the two whistle bodies on either side of the dividing wall. So the glue's kind of dried on here, and now I can add the other side, and I want to line up these slots here and also the way the air comes in here. Before I proceed, I'm going to cut out the shape of this thing, which will be governed by the large cavity, and this is easiest to do before I glue everything together. I cut the mahogany sides a little bit oversized so that I can, I don't have to be that precise about it. And now I can clamp this together for a final fit before I try to glue things. When I was tweaking the shape of it, I always set the gap in here, which is very critical, just by sticking a piece of wood in here, and so now I can reproduce this gap exactly the same way. So now I just have to let that glue set before I go any further. Now, very important to put the pea in, and I must not blow this whistle while the glue dries, because I don't want the pea to get stuck on the drying glue. So let's just clamp the one side together and leave that for a while. Now with the glue fully dried, I can trim it to its final size.
All done. Sounds a bit like a loon, eh?